Hello, Mga Nation. Today on Get Real, we'll be talking about reverse mortgages. Now, do you know that the reverse mortgage has been around since 1961? Since then, it's gone through many developmental milestones and changes to make it the safe financial tool it is today for our retirees. But the question is, bakit ang dami pa rin taong alinlangan na pumunta sa reverse mortgage route? Why is there that concept that it's too good to be true? Well, Rob and Ning are here today to set the record straight and get real with reverse mortgages. Hello, guys.
Hi, JC.
Okay, so let's start with a scenario. I have a home. It's fully paid. And when I die, I want my kids to inherit the property, right? Mm-hmm. Fairly common right. situation. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Now, is it ideal for me to do a reverse mortgage now, given that scenario?
Well, if I'm 62 and I'm sitting on equity, not earning any income, and we all need income when we retire, I definitely would think about a reverse mortgage and turn my house into an annuity mm-hmm. or get cash mm-hmm. with no payments.
Okay.
It's a definite great vehicle for that.
Ning, where does the too good to be true perception come from? Or where does it stem from?
Yeah, kasi as we all know, nagbabayad tayo ng mortgage natin, halos kalahati ng kinikita natin mortgage. And so,
for majority of our lives, we're paying
exactly.
mortgage, yeah.
How come na pwede kang magstay sa bahay mo and you still own the property nang hindi ka magbabayad ng mortgage? Mm-hmm. So that's probably kind of like, oh my God, this is too good to be true.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Dahil ang I think ang naiisip nila is my house will be taken by the mm-hmm. by the bank mm-hmm. kapag nawala ako,
yeah.
which is absolutely not true.
Okay. So give us some situations, some typical situations where a reverse mortgage makes sense. I'm retired, 62 and above, my house is fully paid or not, and I need some money. Mm-hmm. I will do a reverse mortgage and use that money to do basically whatever I want.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no, is there a qualification needed?
Well, yes.
Like, do I need to have good credit? Do I need to have, like...
So, yeah, I mean, there still are qualification procedures, mm-hmm. but it's much easier than a typical loan. Mm-hmm. In a typical loan, FHA, and these are FHA loans, by the way, mm-hmm. in many cases, you have to qualify income-wise for the payment, principal, interest, taxes, and insurance. In a reverse mortgage, all you have to qualify for is to show that you can pay your property taxes mm-hmm. and insurance. Much easier to qualify for.
Yeah, unless you live in Beverly Hills where property taxes are a lot of
well,
20 grand a year or something. Yeah, anyway.
Yeah, so yung credit din, hindi sila masyadong sa credit. You know, you don't need to have 720 credit to be able to qualify. Mm-hmm. And in fact, kahit nga may derogatory, you can qualify. Mm-hmm. Kaya nga lang, tumataas yung requirement in terms of yung kung ano yung equity mo sa property. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's just a quick and easy calculation in terms of qualification and really just enjoying the equity that you have mm-hmm. now mm-hmm. instead of later.
Let's give our viewers sort of a better visual here. In this graphic, we're seeing that the home value is 500,000, mm-hmm. home equity line of credit 250K, interest rate 4.5%. Please walk us through this graphic.
Okay, so the reason why we said pwede siguro yung home equity line of credit 250 is because pag 62 tayo, karamihan ng reverse mortgage 50% requirement ng equity. Mm-hmm. So kung ano yung interest rate na ibinigay sa atin when we refinance through reverse, mm-hmm. yun din yung interest rate na pwedeng mag-earn yung ating home equity line of credit kung hindi natin yung gagalawin. Mm-hmm. So ang home equity line of credit is just right there mm-hmm. na po pwede nating i-cash out anytime we want to, right? Mm-hmm. And so, kung hindi natin siya gagalawin, yung 4.5% na example nating interest rate, it builds yung 250, so tataas siya kasi nag-earn siya ng interest. Okay. Pero pag ginalaw mo, let's say you pulled 50,000, yung 50,000 at 4.5%, yun lang ang utang mo dun sa property.
Really, really quick example before we wrap things up, Rob. So, we're retired. We want to take on 250,000 in home equity for the reverse mortgage, mm-hmm. yes. And I want to make sure that my kids can also still inherit the house mm-hmm. after we die.
Yeah.
What happens if parents die, they have this amount that
yeah.
they have to pay back. Mm-hmm. What happens there?
Well, great question, because that's where all the misinformation is around, because most people think that when you do a reverse mortgage, the bank takes your home when you pass on. Not true. It's a loan. And so what happens when you pass, your kids, whoever you give your property to, will have the right to your home. Now, if they're 62, they may be able to take over the reverse mortgage. If they're not, they'll need to refinance to a regular loan, mm-hmm. right? Or sell the property and take the remaining equity and distribute to the heirs.
So it's such a great product, yeah. such a great tool. Like, you know, yeah. in a perfect world, we're all fully paid, 62, and just yeah. living the good life, right?
Right.
Yeah. But
mm-hmm.
anyway, right. so for those of you viewers who are in that situation,
that's a great
this
product.
Good information.
Well, but you know, reverse mortgage also applies kung meron tayong loan, pero you know, it's equity driven. Mm-hmm. So you can purchase, you can refinance through reverse mortgage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, you can purchase as well. Yeah.
If you want to find out more about reverse mortgages or anything about mortgages, Rob and Ning are here, and that's why they're here on Get Real to help our Canations. And so, Rob, if they have mm-hmm. questions, how can they reach you guys?
Sure, JC. Thank you. Canation, you can call us at 888-860-9530, or you can visit us online.
All right. That's it for Get Real this week.